Hi, and welcome to this tutorial video. My name is Ian David Marsden, and I'm a cartoonist and illustrator. You can see more of my work on my website, which is marsdenillustration.com, and I'm also on Facebook as Ian David Marsden. So if you feel like liking my page, I would, of course, appreciate that very much. That way, you would always be updated whenever I upload new videos to my YouTube channel and all kinds of other things that I get up to. This tutorial video is about drawing line art in Adobe Illustrator. The sketch in the background was created in Autodesk SketchBook Pro 6 software, and I have another video here on my YouTube channel that shows how I created that, if you feel like watching it. I simply imported that onto a layer in Illustrator and turned it into a template and grayed it out to 50%, and now I'm drawing my line art over it. The brushes that I'm using here, the brush strokes, are taking advantage of the pressure sensitivity and angle stroke of my stylus on my Wacom Cintiq tablet. This is a wonderful thing because it basically simulates what I would have had if I was drawing with a real pen and ink nib and pressing harder on the paper. But of course here I can also undo, I can redo. Erasing India ink on paper is not fun, or shall we say it's not even possible. The other advantage here, of course, this is vector art, so when this is finished, it has no resolution, it has no pixels, and it can be scaled to any size from football field to postage stamp. As you can see here, I am using my own sketch as a guideline, but I'm not sticking to it. It's not written in stone. If I feel like if I feel like changing something, I will, or slightly modifying it. I do, however, try to have a sketch that is pretty much the way I want it, because that way I can confidently go in there and ink it, and I know that the final art is going to look the way I want it. I also know that it's going to fit with the other elements that I'm going to use, depending on what I'm doing. This is a good example of a tiny little seemingly unimportant line, but I didn't like it, so I redid it 5 times. And sometimes I do it 20 times, because sometimes I'm a bit of a maniac. What I like to do then is I save my lines, so I have them in a symbol, in case I want to have the editable lines at my disposal. Then I flatten the artwork. I created a paint object, and then I expanded it. That allows me to delete the overlapping lines in a very quick and efficient and clean way. I don't even have to erase them. This is what I'm doing here. It's a cool little trick. I don't always do that, but pretty much find it a very efficient and time-saving trick. So there you go. Here I found all the little bits that I don't want to overlap. I'm doing a little bit of cleanup. Now I have the main lines. Now I'm going to go in and create a little more detail, such as the 3D overlap there of the carving and the pumpkin, the eyes. Shading. Basically, even though it's Illustrator and even though this is vector art, I have a freehand feeling of drawing here, which is really great. I have to say I mostly create line art in Illustrator. I sometimes use Manga Studio MX4. It's a program I like very much too, because it also kind of gives you that realistic comic book feeling. It has some advantages too if you want to have panels, comic pages, and bubbles and lettering, speech, you know, text bubbles, etc. I almost never draw digital line art as bitmaps because it just gets pixelated and it cannot be scaled. I don't know if I want to use this later much bigger or smaller. Even if I wanted to do a hyper-shaded, realistic Photoshop shading here with highlights and lens flares and everything, I would still bring the line art in from Illustrator. And I would probably keep it as a smart object inside Photoshop so that I could even in there scale it losslessly. What I'm doing here now is I'm laying down flats or shading. This is maybe a strange way of doing this, but I like working this way. In my mind, I kind of already know what I want to have shaded and how I want it to look, so I simply use the pen tool and draw the outlines of the shading, and it fills in nicely with a nice flat black. This takes a little bit of practice, obviously, and this maybe not everybody's piece of cake, but I find it fantastic. And anybody who used to work with brushes and pen and ink knows that those big black spaces that need to be filled in sometimes can be a major hassle. And I mean, if you can see here how relatively quickly and incredibly cleanly this is being done here, it's just a pleasure. I have to admit that this is a drawing that's simply going to go on my Facebook page, so I cannot spend all day on it. And also for the purpose of this video, that it doesn't turn into a 4-hour video, I am working relatively quickly here. So, you know, it is somewhat, not rushed, but it's somewhat basic. So there you have it, flat shading, everything in Adobe Illustrator. Of course, this could even be saved as a movie symbol and imported into Flash. And it can be imported into a whole bunch of other software too. But it just gives you this wonderful, clean, crisp, scalable artwork. And I love to work like that. Some final touches there. The pumpkin ridges. I'm going to give them a dark orange color and drop them behind the black lines. Here I'm just cleaning up with the eraser. And there you pretty much have it. If you saw my first video where I drew the sketch for this, you can see that there's a jack-o'-lantern, there's a vampire, and there's a werewolf. So there are two more videos of me inking the vampire and me inking the werewolf, plus, of course, the video how I created the sketch in the background. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial. Thank you very much for watching, and like I said, please visit me on my Facebook, on my homepage, and come back to my YouTube channel. I'll be uploading more videos. Feel free to drop me a message, or if you want to ask me a question, I'll be happy to answer it. I might not answer it the next day, but I will get around to it. So, don't hesitate. Thank you very much for watching, and more soon.